Kid, or Planet in Distress, is a stylish puzzle platformer on PlayStation Network, Xbox Live Arcade, and Steam, and it's a lot of fun. In many ways, it reminds me of the quirky PSN game Rochard, in which players were tasked with controlling gravity in order to complete puzzles and proceed. Pid also hinges on the use of gravity, but it takes a different tack than Rochard, relying more on ambience and overt difficulty. And while Pid certainly has its problems, it's a game that those looking for a challenge are going to enjoy. In Pid, players control a young boy named Kurt. Launched onto another planet and desperate to find his way home, Kurt is tasked with traversing a wide array of environments as he solves puzzles, platforms, and occasionally battles strange foes. As you can see, Pid is a beautiful game. It's not going to shock and awe you with its graphical fidelity per se, but the game has a sort of pristine appearance that successfully melds the old school with the new school. Backgrounds and foregrounds burst, the color palette is vibrant, and character models are strange, yet fitting. Pid dares to sacrifice realism for the fantastic, a decision that fits in well with Pid's equally fantastic story. But perhaps the biggest standout in Pid is its amazing soundtrack, one that feeds off of so many inspirations. Multiple times, Greg Miller, who sits next to me here at IGN, commented about how awesome the soundtrack is without ever really taking more than a cursory look at the game otherwise. Pid really does stand out in the audio department, and it may make you turn up the volume on your television. Everything in Pid revolves around manipulating gravity. In the beginning of the game, Kurt acquires a mystical orb that, when launched, creates a sort of gravity well that he can float in. Kurt can launch two wells at a time, and the game hinges on figuring out how to use them in constant unison. These gravity wells can even affect enemies and objects, but only certain ones. Blue enemies, as well as blue platforms, are immune to the effects of gravity, while red enemies and their projectiles can be caught and manipulated. Of course, Kurt will also have other items at his disposal. Vests give him extra health, bombs can destroy enemies, and much more. For the most part, Pid is straightforward enough, and it's usually clear what you have to do to proceed, even if it takes you many tries. But some puzzles are obtuse and outright frustrating, and when Pid gets away from puzzle platforming and mild combat and more into exploration, the game can become annoying. I reached a point midway through the game so vague that I had to ask the developer for help. If I was playing the game for fun, I would have stopped at that point. Then again, I'm glad I didn't. Even if Pid is occasionally inconsistent and will inevitably frustrate you from time to time, it's still a fun, worthwhile game. One with a unique set of gameplay mechanics that take a little while to get used to, but one that's ultimately rewarding when you finally master what you're supposed to do. I beat Pid in just under 11 and a half hours. You can do it a little quicker if you're great at puzzle games. Beating the game will unlock a hard mode, giving you a reason to go back for more. And there are plenty of collectibles and hidden areas to find if you so desire, giving you even more reasons to go back. When I played Pid a couple of times before it came out, I was in love with it. The final product didn't quite meet those expectations, and the game locked up on me twice on PS3. But Pid is still a decidedly good game. It has a flair for presentation and characters, from the planet's strange inhabitants to the bosses you'll occasionally fight, the latter being one of the coolest parts of the game. And its gameplay is unique and fluid, even if it will frustrate you from time to time. For more on Pid and all things downloadable games, keep it tuned to IGN.com.